Thank you for spending a little time with me and welcome to my little corner YouTube. Before I get started, what did I want to tell you? Oh yes, the project that I was working on has come and gone. I am now back on day shift, so I'm doing the first in a very long time, which is recording during the day. Because the video is a little choppy, know that I had to cut out the dogs barking, people knocking at my door, and just general people barging in because I don't have a sign that says that I'm recording. You'd figure I'd done that by now, but I keep procrastinating. Okay, so this video is for anybody who's starting on with, you know, Manga Studio or Clip Studio Paint, have not read the instructions yet. I will have you know beforehand that if you use Photoshop, if you're used to Photoshop, it's a much more intensive program because that program is for, you know, manipulating pictures and images. Manga Studio is a tad bit simpler, mainly because it's for comic book artists or just plain illustration. So I have found it to be very helpful to me as far as doing comic book work. It's very intuitive. You know, as to where Photoshop, there was a major learning curve, especially with all the other Adobe programs that can be used with it. Manga Studio files can be used in Photoshop and Photoshop files used in Manga Studio. But there are some small differences, and I'll touch upon some of that on the video. For now, I'm gonna do three things. Let me look and see. Okay, one is gonna be the easiest one that I could think of was how to blue line. Second one is how to remove the white of an image if you are going to color. How to resize an image or a layer. Let's get started. For this procedure, Manga Studio has made it very easy. Go to your file, open, find your file, and open it in your Manga Studio / Clip Studio Paint. At this point, you are going to go towards the right side of your screen and you will see a button that has a color on it. Now, blue is not necessarily the only color. Once you're there, you can choose the color, but I already have it set up to non-photo blue. You press it and it's ready to go. You create a new raster size layer. Choose your tool. In this case, I'm using the pen since it's for inking. Make sure that it's black. Pick the size of your tip and, you know, you can go ahead and go to town on that image. That image is ready to go. Now, if you want to save this file as a blue line image with the option to change it back to black, make sure that when you go to your file, save as, you pick the following file type. Manga Studio. There is a Photoshop document file, but if you pick it as a Photoshop document, the minute you close that file and you open it back up, it'll be permanent blue line. So make sure you use the Manga Studio file so you can have the option to change it back. On this operation, we are going to resize an image. So we're going to open a new file. For this one, I'm using 11 by 17 at 300 dpi, which is standard comic book page size printable. Then I am going to open a new file that is of a different size. Now you can do this with a file without opening a new layer. I chose it to do this way because in my mind it's a lot easier to do. So you're going to go to selection, select all, edit, you're going to go to copy. Now you're gonna open your new file, go back to edit and paste. As you can see, the file is on there, but is a lot bigger than our original file. So we're gonna have to change the size of it. We are going to go back to edit, transform, resize. Now, if you have not noticed, whenever I opened any of those commands, you're gonna see that on the right-hand side of the tab, there is a shortcut, which is something that I like, that Manga Studio gives you. So once you get proficient at doing this, you can learn the shortcuts, and it goes a lot faster when you're using your keyboard alongside the program. Now, as you can see, the file has been resized. You can press any of these buttons over here, and that'll bring the prompt that you need for applying of the resizing. And that is it. You have now resized your image. Okay, and this is the final procedure. I am going to show you how to remove the white of an image for the purpose of coloring. There are many ways of doing this, and I've seen plenty of videos on YouTube on how to do it. One of the most common ones is to create a layer. As you can see, when you try to color, you can't see anything until you go to your line layer and put it on darken. Then you can see what's being done underneath. That is fine if that is the way you like doing it. I prefer to remove the white and just leave the line work on there. For that, you go back to your file, place it on normal, go to the select tab, click on select color gamut, put your dropper where you want the color to be taken out, and as you can see, we already got the ants surrounding everything. And this little toolbar is gonna pop out at the bottom. Now, I like this toolbar in Clip Studio Paint Manga Studio because it has a lot of shortcuts in it. One is to increase the size of the marching ants. One is to decrease the size of the marching ants if you want to clip some of the material that you're working with. One clears inside the selection, one clears outside of the selection. I do believe this last one here is for resizing the selection. And this last one here is so you can, you know, organize it any way you want it to. But if you go right to the clear selection, now we have removed all the white pixels, and you can zoom in and check your image and you will see that. It's a simple, easy procedure, and it gets rid of anything that is not black. At this point, you can go ahead and color underneath without risk of coloring over your line work. We are now getting to the end. I would like to quickly thank Mr. Carl Waller for allowing me to use his artwork in the making of this video. If you saw anything that piqued your interest, please like and subscribe. If you want to pass the information along, feel free to share. My name is Rick Bonilla. Thank you for spending a little time with me, and have a great day.